Graph the function f of x equals 3x squared. This is a quadratic function. And notice it's just the x squared term. There's no x term, there's no constant term. This means that the function has a vertex at 0, 0. Okay, and I also know the pattern for an x squared function or parabola. And it depends on this 3 in front of the x squared. So basically what you do is you use this first term to create the other points that you're going to be plotting. So I have a 3x squared and 3 times 1 squared is 3 times 1 or 3. So I'm going to go over 1 to the right and then up 3. That is going to be my next point. I use this first term, or the x squared term, and the distance from the vertex, and then I simply find how high up to go. The next point over three times two squared is three times four, which is 12. So I'm going to go over two from the vertex and up 12. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. There's my next point. Now normally I would continue and do one more point. That's going to be 3 times 9, which is 27, and that's way off the graphing grid, and it's not really necessary here. So my next step is to use symmetry. A parabola has symmetry right through the vertex. So basically all I'm doing is I'm reflecting these two points that I plotted through the vertical line that the vertex goes through. It's called the axis of symmetry. Okay, so here are my points I'm using to draw my graph. And you just have to be careful here. I mean, drawing a parabola is a little challenging. You don't want to make it look like a V, it's more like a U. So let's give this a shot here and see how it goes. Okay, so there's our parabola. And this is the function f of x equals 3x squared. So just to summarize, you plot the vertex, then you use the first term, 3x squared in this case, and then you go ahead and determine how high up you go, or the vertical change for each move to the right from the vertex. And then finally, you reflect those points and draw your parabola.